Hello guys, welcome back to the Tenorshare channel. The iOS 15 beta was just released recently, so I know a lot of you guys have been rushing to update, which is amazing indeed. But for the bugs and potential risks of a beta software, you might want to go back to the stable version of iOS 14 while still keeping your data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to safely downgrade your device back to iOS 14, of course without losing any data. So, let's get into it. The first thing we want to do is go to ipsw.me. This is where we are going to download the official version of iOS 14. So once you are here, go ahead and click on iPhone. I'm using an iPhone 12, so I'm gonna click this one. Now you can see right here is assigned IPSW file, which is the latest version of iOS 14. So we go ahead and click on it. Now we see the details right here. Go ahead and click download. Once it's downloaded, we can plug our device into the computer. Then let's open iTunes and go to the device page. Now we are going to back up the device to this computer. If you already have backups which you created on iOS 14, you can skip this step and go ahead with the downgrade in this video. If not, you can do it now. So once the backup is finished, we are gonna restore the device back to iOS 14. Before we do that, let's go to iPhone settings, tap your name, then find my, and go ahead to turn it off. This is a necessary step before the restore. Once done, we switch back to iTunes. Press the Shift key and click Restore iPhone at the same time. Then, in the pop-up window, we select the IPSW file we just downloaded and click on Open. It says iTunes will erase and restore your phone to iOS 14. We click Restore. Then your iPhone should restart. Once it completed, you should see the Hello screen. By the way, if you have difficulty using iTunes, ReiBoot will be a nice alternative, which works like this. Click on Reset Device on the home screen, then proceed with the factory reset. Click Import Local Firmware, select the iOS 14 IPSW file we downloaded, then click Open. ReiBoot will detect it right away, then you can start downgrading. See, ReiBoot is the trick too. Let's go ahead and set it up. So when we get to the app and data screen, choose don't transfer apps and data. We'll do it later once we are on the home screen. Okay, now let's go to settings and check it out. As you can see, we are on iOS 14 now. But of course, we don't have any data just yet. So now we are going to restore from the backup we made earlier today. Before we proceed, we should note that the backup we create on iOS 15 is not compatible with the official version of iOS 14, so we need to make some changes to the backup so it can assimilate. So we press Win and R key at the same time, type in %appdata%, and hit OK. Now we're going to Apple Computer, Mobile Sync, then Backup. Judged by last modified time, this should be the backup we created just before. Let's get inside the folder, and then we scroll down to bottom, and we can find the info.plus file. Open it up with the notepad. Press Ctrl and F to pen the search tool and search for the word product. Not too far down we'll find the product version. Below it we can see iOS 15. What we are going to do is change it to iOS 14. Well done. Now we can save the change and close this file. And then let's connect the device and go to iTunes to restore from the modified backup. Make sure Find My is still disabled at this point. Then we select Restore from this backup, and make sure it's the backup we just modified, and hit Continue. iTunes will start restoring all your data from the backup. All you need to do is enter the device passcode when prompted. So after the restore is finished, we'll see the Hello screen again. And then it says Restore completed. We tap Continue. Go through a few setups to the home screen. Then here we go. As you can see, everything we have previously is back on the device now. We even got the iOS 15 wallpaper. But of course, the software version is still iOS 14. So guys, this is how you can downgrade your device from iOS 15 back to iOS 14. Hope you enjoy this video. This is Tenorshare channel. See you in the next one.